Hi, my name's Dr. Peter Frederick, and I'm a gynecologic oncologist here at the Roswell Park Comprehensive Cancer Center in Buffalo, New York. So cervical cancer is typically asymptomatic in the early stages, and so that's one of the main reasons why we recommend screening with pap tests or HPV tests or a combination of those, because women may have precancerous changes of the cervix that have absolutely no symptoms at all. By doing pap test screening and HPV screening, we can identify these precancerous changes before they have a chance to turn into cancer. Once cervical cancer does develop, in some cases we'll see more advanced stages, and in those situations, abnormal bleeding is a commonly encountered symptom. Sometimes patients will describe bleeding after intercourse. Other symptoms that can be seen with more advanced cervical cancer can include urinary issues, pelvic pressure, vaginal discharge could be another symptom. Sometimes there's a foul vaginal discharge. And again, these are more commonly seen in the more advanced stages. But I think the main take-home message for cervical cancer is that it's important to have regular screening as your healthcare provider recommends. And the vast majority of women that have regular pap tests or HPV tests will not go on to develop cervical cancer. It's very important for all of our patients and all of us to just be aware of what our body's telling us. And so I think some of us try to minimize symptoms and say, well, this isn't so bad, maybe it will go away on its own. But if something doesn't go away on its own, that's your body trying to tell you that maybe something's wrong. And sometimes early identification of these abnormal signs and symptoms can be potentially life-saving, because with some of these cancers, the earlier they're detected, the more treatable they can be.